What's up, guys? I'm at the comic book store. Looking at these back issues. What's up, guys? Welcome back to another exciting comic book haul. This is episode number 117. Let's hit off right off the bat. All right, so I got Shadow Man number 13 from the comic book store. Typically, it's really hard to find key issues, but once in a while, you might dig up something new that the owner knows nothing about. Now, most of you guys are thinking, what's so special about a Valiant comic? Why, this is the first appearance of Punk Mambo. She has her own series that came out, and she's very popular right now, so she's probably Valiant's version of Harley Quinn. Up-and-coming character that has dark powers, magical powers, think of Doctor Strange, but she's got a spectacular look to it, got the punk mohawk hair, and just a badass with a lot of tattoos and stuff. So I'm very happy to have this in my collection, guys. You guys find it, grab more than one copy of its cover price. All right, so here we go. Starting off with some typical clearance items, you know. I've had this for a while. I've been wanting to do a haul, but just didn't get time to do it. But now I don't really buy any comics with price stickers unless they're super key issues. So this is Silent Hill Dying Inside from Konami, one of these video game-based comics from IDW, one of the smaller publishing companies. Spider-Woman Origin. The art looks like it's from the Nunes Brothers. I highly recommend you guys check out the sword and other Nunes Brothers works. Amazing. And why did I buy this? Who knows? The Desert King. I don't know anything about this. Retroactive Justice League America. Number one, one shot. Like I mentioned, I probably had this haul for like maybe a year or two. So now, going back in time, I probably wouldn't buy this again. Sword of Dracula number one. Astonishing X-Men number one with Wolverine Claw. Pretty iconic cover right there. Speaking of claws, we have a Black Cat team up with Wolverine. Looking a little bit funky with the art right there. The goddamn issue number one from Image Comics. Who knows, one of these days this might be a TV series. And this is collecting Ultimate X-Men 1, 2, and 3 collected edition. Another Justice League. This is the Cry for Justice series. Issue 5. Love in Dismemberment. Looks like Shazam's hooking up with Supergirl right there. Here's issue number 4. Shazam. Green Lantern. Green Arrow. Who else is in the power of Adam and who are Supergirl? Here's issue number 1. Pretty nice cover right there. I'm digging that. Got Batwoman. She's supposed to have her own series in DC Universe. And by the way, I think I heard that they canceled Swamp Thing. I have yet to watch it, but that's not good news for the DC Universe of their streaming service. The Green Hornet number one. You don't see this cover too often. Of course, big shout out to Bruce Lee. Rest in peace. The best martial artist ever. Got some of these graphic novels. Just good for reading. Kingdom Come, both Alex Ross art right there. Elseworld. X-Men Rarities. I don't know that much about this. You don't see this too often. Just give you a quick sneak peek. It's going to be a great read. Art is underwhelming, though. Actually, the art looks like somebody drew it from grade school. No diss on the artist, but that's my opinion, right? Guy Gardner Reborn. I'm looking forward to seeing Guy Gardner. I mean, now they have Lobo and Krypton. I want to see Guy Gardner. If DC get their shit together, you know, maybe their movies would be more consistent and enjoying. Here's issue number 2, Cry for Justice. And number 3, with Green Lantern. Oh, I like this cover right here, man. That really stands out, isn't it? Got the great cover color. Got the character positioning. Everything just looks awesome, man. If that was glow in the dark, hoo-wee. And Superman Doomsday Under Prey. And from a previous haul, I remember these were autographed comics. So I decided to go back and get the rest of these. See, autographed by Tom Linton, I think. These manga series, kind of like ash can, oversized ash can editions. Gurion. This is book one. Actually, these are separate stories. Oh, no, my bad. That's number three. And here's issue number two. Also with the autograph on the interior. Viking, thanks to support, buddy. See right there? Sometimes you have to look carefully. Not all the clearance items are junk. And here's a variant edition. I think it's a sketch edition. Just the brightest day. Generation Lost number one. Dragonlance number one. I figure, you know, it's issue number one. It's a little bit hard to find from TSR. Sometimes you just have to grab number ones. Oh, by the way, that's 25 cents I pay for those. Ming Spider-Man 388. Special double size issue with Life Theft, the final chapter. I think they're going, that's where Peter Parker's parents dies again. Marvel Girl. Fantastic art right there. And speaking of which, I'm going to hit up AMC Theaters for the X-Men Dark Phoenix tonight. So I'm a little bit excited about that. But not too much because the reviews came out were pretty bad. It was like, you know, 22% people from Rotten Tomatoes thought it was 50% or higher. So that's very low. G.I. Joe number one. No, this isn't the Marvel editions. I wish I had. Oh, actually, I do have that G.I. Joe number one. But this is the image version. G.I. Joe number one. Usagi Yojimbo, the fighting rabbit. The Ronin Master. Usagi Yojimbo. Dungeons and Masters. This is the Comic Con Zero Edition Packs 2010. That's a variant cover. I love these Wolverine Old Man Logan. This is the missing issue, number 70, Mark Millar, Steve McNiven. Awesome writing, awesome art. Definitely Steve McNiven, top 20 artists. And this one, what's this about? Why did I buy this? Oh, because it's autographs. Scrap Pictures, Blazing Brandy. There's an autograph right there from Bezniak. Here's another one. Autograph right there. That's going great. Goes great in my autograph collection. And here's Beauty Killer. Wizard World East exclusive preview edition. Signed by the one and only Adam Hughes. I was on Alan Davis. Adam Hughes. So inside each page that Adam Hughes drew, he autographed it with the AH exclamation. Spider-Man, this is the Prevent Child Abuse edition, not for resale, back in 2001-9-11. See the commemorative logo right there. So this one is definitely harder to find, more rarity. Amazing Spider-Man number 8. This is the who knows, like volume 5 or whatever they're up to right now. That's ridiculous. They should have kept it at you know, increase the numbers. Stop changing up the volumes. And I believe this first appearance of the spider car. Goddess Mode. Something this tells me that this will eventually have its own show. I'm pretty sure that's the first appearance of Goddess Mode. From DC Vertigo. Now I grabbed this because it features the first appearance of Grimjack. Yes, Grimjack isn't that popular, but I like first appearances. And kind of racist with the meek black Tom, right? I very love this cover right here. So iconic and so beautiful. Second printing of Venom 2. I just wish I had the first printing. Because that one is in real pretty in the collector's edition. For something like $40 or something like that. Cable and Deadpool, very last issue of Cable and Deadpool, number 50. Final issue. That was on my list once. And I finally have this in my collection. Admire the art, guys. Look at how detailed it is. There's no way somebody drew this. No freaking way. This would have taken like probably like the whole day to draw. Look at how detailed this is. I have a feeling this is probably like computerized, you know? They did it on computer. I don't know, maybe like copied images and just paste it all together and make it work like that. That is very iconic cover too. And it's not cheap, guys. $7.99 cover price. So I paid at half price, what I paid, you know, half of that, like $3.99-ish. Kingdom Come, another Alex Ross graphic novel. Another one, Golden Age. These Elseworlds a pretty great read. More dark and mature. Another Elseworld, Golden Age. Harlequin DC Universe Rebirth, number one. One of the variant covers. Here's Superman. Wonder Woman, the new 52 sketch variant length cover. Batman Detective Comics, number 27, New 52. There's a free edition, special edition. Another one. Probably give one of these away. And I grabbed a whole bunch of these True Believers. It was 25 cents. I already removed the price stickers. This is a free number one. Finally have it. But unfortunately, it's True Believers. So True Believers are like $1 edition of the key issues that Marvel just want people to read for people who can't afford it, I guess. Here is a Marvel Comics Presents number one, Save the Tiger, the Origin number one, the True Believers. Here's a Wolverine Enemy of the State, John Romita Jr. art, I believe. Here's a nice one, Wolverine X-23 number one. Amazing Spider-Man 420, a Twist the Night Before X-Man. Here's a Scooby-Doo number one, presented by Burger King. This one of these giveaways and a couple of these, The Walking Dead number one special Emerald City Comic Con exclusive. There you go. And The Adventures of Kool-Aid Man. Kool-Aid Man. Yes, he had his own comics. And they're basically comics of everything they can think of. Alright guys, we're going to switch it up a little bit. Avengers number 343. I believe that has the first appearance of the Gatherers. They are like a group of almost like eternal gods, I think, with superpowers and longevity. Who knows, they might be in the upcoming Marvel movie. And here's continuing on. You got the duo, the Dark Knights. Got Swordsman versus Black Knight. I'm looking forward to Black Knight being in the Marvel Universe for real, though. Even though he's pretty weak, but he just... His setup is ridiculous. Looks really awesome and rad. Yeah, I want to see that horse, too. Quantum Woody, number one. Big shout out to Valiant Comics, underrated publishing company, and Reed. Faith in the Future Force, number one. I got a couple of these sexy steampunk angels, Victorian secret agents. A pinup ones, I think. Where's the other one? Here's another one. Real good art, too, by the way. Who is the artist? This is 2013 one. Big shout out to the artist, too. Very distinctive. I like that. And... The Great Lake Avengers, what can I say about them? Great Lakes, you can think of probably like Michigan or something like that. Or Wisconsin, I think that's where they're based. So you have Avengers, West Coast Avengers. Dark, well, I'm not even talking about Dark Avengers. So Great Lake Avengers is a location-based Avengers with these. They have weird powers, that's all I can say. I highly doubt they will ever get their own movie. Dr. Mirage, Second Lives, pretty cool art. Dr. Mirage, you know, in the background. Hard to see. Shadow Man number one. Funky cover right there. Pretty creepy. Alright, I got another one of these signed comic. Can you guys spot the signature? Cody and the Creepies from Boombox. There's a signature right there from 2017. So signed by Liz Prince, LP. And he drew some like a snail or whatever the heck that is. Got a couple of these Betty and Veronica variant editions. That's the Stephanie Buscema variant cover, and this is the regular cover, I think. And no, I did not read it. I probably won't read it because I'm not really a big fan of Archie Comics. Oops, excuse me, guys, excuse me. Alright, guys, so I did a quick comic book half price books haul. Let's see what I got today. Got a couple of these Seattle Comic Con Walking Dead exclusive. Here's the winner right here, guys. What's so special about this DC Spotlight 50? And it's signed by Jerry Siegel. Why, it's the first appearance of Watchmen and The Dark Knight Returns for 25 cents. Admire it. It's beautiful. Looks like we got a couple other goodies. Can't wait to remove these prize stickers. Some exclusive and variant covers of this Kool-Aid Man one. 90s Amazing Spider-Man. What's this one? Prevent Child Abuse one. Yeah, this is gonna be hot. I'm telling you guys, I am so lucky to have this. Found it in the clearance section of half price books. I wasn't even going to bother buying it until I researched. And surely enough, this is the very first appearance of Watchmen and also the Dark Knight. And in addition to that, guys, it is autographed. Let's see what the autograph says. Love to Margie from Siegel. I believe that's the writer, Jerry Siegel. Can't read the rest. And Jerry Siegel right there. So this is autographed twice. Beautiful. Look at that. I guess back then this was a free edition, so I'm very happy to have that. That's going to go in my MVP collection and the folders, yes. And to finish off this haul, what is going on in value? Why, it is Marvel's Power Pack number one. Who is Power Pack? I believe they are like a new mutants version, except they're not mutants. It features a couple of Reed Richards kids, like Franklin Richards, his son. They have like these funky powers, nothing too explosive, anything like that. And I heard there might be an upcoming Power Pack Marvel movie. We'll wait and see. So if you guys find this, definitely grab it. I hope you guys won't be disappointed. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button. Until next time, happy collecting.